Wallahi, I don't care who you are. I don't care what sins you've committed in your life. I don't care what your condition is right now. And I don't care what the world tells you about you. You are special to Allah. Allah loves you. And you're a Muslim. And you are beautiful. You are smart. You are intelligent. You are brave. You are forgiving. You are loving. You are well-mannered. You're a Muslim. You're the one. You, my brother. Yes, you. Not me. You. I'm talking to every person that's sitting here, to every person that's watching, to every person that's listening. You. You. Yes, you. You are the one that can change the world. You are the one that can take humanity from the misery that it's in to the happiness and the joy that it can have with Allah. You are the one, single-handedly, you are the one that can take humanity from the darkness that we're in to the light of Allah Azza wa Jal and the light of Islam. You need to believe in yourself. Don't let people put you down. Don't let people convince you otherwise. You are special. You are a creation of Allah. Today the world is seeking happiness. Today the world is seeking the approval of men. People try to tell me that we want equality for women. I've never heard so much rubbish in my life. Today, a woman, the closer she is, the more she is like men, then the more honored and liberated she is. Allah says no. Allah says the more you are like the way I created you, like the way I designed you, like the way I fashioned you, then the more honored you are. Allah says, I love you just the way you are. Allah says, I don't want you to be anything more than that which you are not. You are special. You are a Muslim. You are the follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look around you and see what's happening. Look around you, my brothers, really, if you haven't noticed what is happening to Muslims and what is happening to Islam, really, you need to wake up. And I'm not the person that's for this whole political and us first step. No. But wallahi, this should be a sign. This should be an inspiration to every Muslim. Wallahi, any religion, any system, any sect, any way of life, if any one of these things was attacked like the way Islam is being attacked, wallahi, it would have collapsed ages ago. Yet Islam is still here. It is still standing. It is still flourishing. You are a Muslim. And Allah is waiting for you. The angels are waiting for you. The Ummah is waiting for you to wake up and come back to Allah. Wake up and start worshipping Allah once more. And if you're worshipping, then take this arrogance out of your heart. We have so much work to do. If we just believed in ourselves, wallahi, for you, Allah will move mountains. The same Allah that split the ocean in half for Musa. The same Allah that split the moon for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The same Allah that stopped the land from its earthquake when Umar ibn al-Khattab hit it. The same Allah that gave life to the dead for Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. The same Allah that made the river, the Nile River, flow once more is the same Allah that's waiting for your next dua. You just got to become like Isa, become like Musa, become like Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, become like Umar ibn Khattab, become like these people, and you watch and see if Allah will do for you what He did for them. My brothers and sisters, I have news for you. You only get one shot at life. There's no coming back.
As you all know, Alhamdulillah, I've passed away. I just wanted to make a little video clip for all the followers that have supported me from day one and come on this journey with me since day one. Allah rewards all you guys, and inshallah you continue to support me and MATW, inshallah. One of the first thing is a little piece of advice to the brothers and sisters as you said, in this life we had. We had the money, we had everything coming in there. SubhanAllah, a lot of people during the period of when I was sick, they'll send me messages, brother, you're guaranteed paradise, brother, you've brother, you've done so much for the community, for the ummah. But subhanAllah, this, yani, it's not worth just the simple blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. Like waking up in the morning and being able to walk to the bathroom by yourself. So these things slowly got stripped away from me during the last of my life, alhamdulillah. Wallahi, some of us don't get that chance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to know when we're going to pass away. Some of us, and a lot of us, just pass away suddenly. We've heard many stories where brothers and sisters have died in clubs, and sisters have died in clubs, or overdosed, whatever it is, subhanAllah. So during your life, brothers and sisters, just try to have a goal, try to have a project that you work towards. Even if it's not you personally doing it, and you're funding someone else's projects, just do something, because Allah, you're going to need it on the day of judgment. And for the brothers and sisters that are chasing, all of my advice to you guys is, this life is becoming, you know, before we used to say 5 years ago, 10 years ago, certain things were happening. Now it's every month things are changing. And you know, Allah, we're following our desires more than we're following Islam these days. We're just gonna be careful, because Allah, it's not a joke anymore. Our kids are getting affected. Everyone's getting affected. Wallahi, sometimes I used to just sit on my bed and cry, because I just wanted that support from people. And then subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings you people that you've never thought or they'll be a part of your life, or friends, or that they existed. When I used to travel, I used to meet certain people. A lot of them actually went out of their way to come all the way from Dubai or UK or wherever it was to come to actually visit me when I was sick or in hospital or sick or in hospital. Or that's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No photo, nothing like that. Just come to visit, 14-hour flight. Just to see if I'm okay, subhanAllah. So, out there that are sick, worried, or stressed, come out. I said to you people, don't worry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send you people that you never expected if you really need someone. You just have to have trust and tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, a little advice for everyone out there. Inshallah, if you can inspire 1, 2, 3 people to do something. Remember, when you're in that grave, inshallah, then you'll be getting rewarded for everything they've done, people they've brought to Islam. And inshallah, that'll help on it day of judgment. So always try to have a project or a plan that you're working towards in this life, inshallah. Inshallah, that'll help us in our grave and the hereafter.